So the next topic which we are going to start with is SQL subqueries. So basically these are the queries which are written within the other queries. So till now we have just written a few queries. Now we are going to create two portions. Basically we are going to divide the query into inner query and the outer query. So the subqueries are the queries which are embedded within a query, and so the name is obviously subquery, also known as the inner query or nested query or the inner select query. And why do we call it inner select query? This you will understand once we see the code. They are a part of another query which is also known as the outer query or the outer select query. A subquery should always be placed within a parenthesis. So suppose now we write a command. So we are going to deal with two tables, the employees table and the department manager table. So basically when I'm going to select from the employees, the department manager table, and we get 24 rows. As you see, we get 24 rows from the department manager table. So there are 24 rows within this table. Now I'm going to add this query in another query basically. And how are we going to do that? Before moving on, so first let me give you the task at hand which we want to do. So the task is that we want the first name and the last name of these managers. So these are the managers which are present in my, these are the data for the managers which is present in the department manager table. What I want is, I want the first name and the last name of these managers, right? Now you will say that the first name and the last name is there in my employees table but not in my departments table. So how do we get this? We will create a subquery. In the previous section we have seen that we use the different kind of joins. Now today we are going to learn about subqueries, how we can create one query and within that how we can add another query. So basically what do you want to do? You want to take up all these employee numbers, search for them in the employees table, in the employees table, and get their respective first name and last name. So see, I'm going to write the query first and then I'll explain. So select we have E dot the first name, E dot the last name from obviously the employees table, where my employee number. So now what do you want? You want to only get the first name and the last name of those employees whose employee number is same as these, because these are the employees who are managers in my company. So I basically want to extract only the information for these particular employees. So my criteria should be that I want to select the first name and the last name from the employees table where the employee number, should be the numbers among these. So I will give a statement in, you if you all remember the in clause, select DM dot employee number Just see the way I'm using the indentation, because it's very important. Once we start writing big queries, we have to create a lot of indentations. Department managers table. So what is this query we are talking about? So we are getting the first name, we're getting the last name from the employees table, where the employee number in the employees table is among the employees which are there in the department's manager table. So this is what I got from here. And the departments, let me just run this once, copy and paste. So let me first run this and show you all. So these are the employees who are managers in my company. I want their respective first name and last name. So what I have done is, I've taken the first name and the last name from the employees table, where the employee number of the employees table is among a part of these employees, is among a part of these employees. So in operator is basically, it will search the employee number, will search across these employees, and we'll get the first name and the last name corresponding to only these employees. So here, this becomes my inner query or the inner select. This becomes my inner select or the inner query. And this entire thing becomes my outer query or the outer select. The terms which we were talking over here. So inner select or the inner query is this particular query, which will give you all the employee numbers from the department manager table. And this is the outer query or the outer select, which will first search for all the employees within this employees and then give you the first name and the last name. So let me now run this. And we are getting 24 rows. Why? Because we had 24 rows in the department manager table. So for the 24 employees, we are getting their first name and the last name. These are the first name and the last name of all the managers in my company. There were 24 rows as an outcome in the department's table, and I got their corresponding first name and last name. So we want first name, last name of the managers only, right? So basically, this is how the SQL engine starts by running the inner query first. So what SQL will do is that SQL will first run this particular query, get all the employee numbers from the department manager table. Then it will search for the employees in the employee numbers in the employees table, which equals to these employee numbers, and then will extract the first name and the last name. So the inner query runs first and then the outer query runs together. So it starts by running the inner query, and then it uses this output, the output of the inner query. It uses this particular output in order to get the outer query. So the inner query, and then it uses the returned output of the inner query, which is the intermediate input, and then executes the outer query using the output of the inner query. So the inner query runs first, gets the output, and uses that while executing the outer query. Okay. So this is a form of using the where clause and the in statement together. A subquery may return a single value or a single row or a single column or an entire table. So this, for our case, it gave us one single column, it might give us a single row, it might give us a single value, it might give us a single column, it can be anything. We can have a lot more than one subquery. So this is only one subquery in one outer query. We can have many number of subqueries, many number of inner queries in one particular outer query. It is possible to nest inner queries within other inner queries. So it is also possible that within this inner query, you are also creating another inner query within this inner query. So you are nesting one inner query inside the other inner query, and then you are putting the outer query, right? So you are basically nesting the inner queries within each other. That is also possible. Just exactly how we write the nested if function in case of Excel, kind of similar here. You are using nested inner queries. Basically, inside one inner query, you are all again. So basically, if this is a query, again within this you are writing another inner query within the brackets. In that case, the SQL engine will execute the innermost query first. So if there is a nested inner queries, the innermost query will be executed first, and then each of the subsequent queries, and then at the end the outermost query. So if you have mentioned a single query within this, a single inner query within this, so that will be executed first, then this will be executed, and then the outer query. So that is how it goes. Okay, now this we use the in function along with the where clause. There is something else also which we can use, which is the exist or not exist along with the where clause. How to do that? I'll copy down the outer query, because the outer query will remain same. So basically here I used in and where. Now I'll show you how to do the same thing. How to do the same thing using the exists command and the where command. My outer query will remain the same, because obviously I need the first name and the last name from the employees table. But now this will change where there exists. First, write the query and then I'll explain. Okay, so now try to understand what I'm trying to do over here. So basically, I'm again selecting the first name and the last name from the employees table, and I am then trying to get all C's. This is my inner query, right? This is my inner query. I am trying to select all the columns from the department's manager table where the department's manager employee number is equal to the employee number in the employees table. So I am now equating the employee number from the department's manager table with the employee number in the employees table. So basically what will happen? All the 24 employees which were there in the department's manager table, I had 24 rows in my department's manager table. All those employees will be equated to the employees number from the employees table. And then on the basis of that, I will get the first name and the last name of only those employees whose employee number is equal to the employee number in the department manager table. So how I changed the query using the exist instead of in clause, and let us see the output. It is exactly same 24 rows which we got using the in clause. Same I've got using the exist clause. I can also order this. So I will write order by the employee number. So I've got the ordered employee number, but generally it is seen that order by is something which you use on the final output. So you should not mention it within the inner query, although the output you will get this is the same in this case. Not always it will be the same, but in this case, just because we have just one single inner query, so we are getting a same output. But if we have more than one inner queries, then it is very optimal not to mention the outer by order by clause over here. Instead of that, to mention the order by clause at the end. So see, after I close the inner query, I order by my entire output. So this is my inner query. Get the output of the inner query, use it to get the output for the outer query, and then order by your entire output on the basis of the employee number. Right? Let me check. Same output, obviously, in this case, but it is always preferable. It's a good practicing habit that you give the order by clause at the end, because you need to order the final output, not the intermediate output, which is the output of the inner query. This is the intermediate output. You need to order the final output. Okay. So now exists checks whether the certain row values are found within the subquery. So basically, this is the subquery. In that, we are selecting all those employee numbers who are common in the employees table and the department's manager table. Then what it will do is, it will check, this outer query basically will check all those first names and the last names and the employee numbers, basically whether these employee numbers exists in this case or not. So it will go row by row and will check that these employees are present or not. If yes, then give me the first name and the last name. So it goes row by row. This checks is conducted row by row and returns a Boolean value. Boolean value means true or false. So if the row exists, if this particular criteria exists, you'll get a true value in this and you'll get the first name and the last name. Again, it will check for the second row. If it is false, you will not get any value. If it is true, you will get the first name and the last name. So if the row value in the subquery exists, so if this value in the inner query exists, the answer is true and you will get the corresponding record in the outer query, which is the first name and the last name. Again, it will check the second row in the employees table. If that matches with that of the department's manager table, that means this is a true value. And that means you will get your first name and the last name. If it will not match, this entire thing will give you a false. This entire thing will give you a false. And you will not get your first name and the last name. Okay. And if the subquery doesn't exist, means that if doesn't exist, the answer will be false. No row from the outer query will be extracted. So no row from the outer query will be extracted. This is how it works. Now, what are the major differences between the using in query and the exist query? Although the output is same, the exist query will test the row by row value. If the row exists, if that particular row exists, then it is fine. You'll get the output. In case of in operator, what happened? First, it extracted all the employee numbers from the department manager table. And then it searched, it took out only those employees from the employees table whose employee number matched with these 24 employee numbers. So basically, this will give you 24 employee numbers. This will give you 24 employee numbers. This employee number will match this employee number will match with these employees, and you will get the final output of first name and the last name. So it searches among the values. So it will search the employee number in the employees table, will search through these numbers in case of in clause. In case of exist clause, it will go row by row. So the main advantage of using exist is that quicker in retrieving the large amount of data. It is faster with the smaller data sets in case of in query. So it is quicker in retrieving the large amount of data in case of exist clause. And it is faster with smaller data sets in case of in clause. So when you have, in our case, we had a smaller data set. So we can use the in clause because we just had 24 rows in the department's manager table. But when we have a very large data set from which we have to look, we will use the exist clause, right? And as I talked about the outer by clause, it is professional to apply it in the outer query instead of inner query, because inner query gives you an intermediate step. It is more acceptable logically to sort the final version of our data set, not the intermediate output. You don't have to sort the intermediate output. So here, you do not have to sort your intermediate output. This will sort your intermediate output and give you the result. But in this case, it will sort your outermost or the finalmost value, which is obviously what we want, right? Some, though not all, nested queries can be rewritten using the joins, which are more efficient. So here in this case, in this particular example, you could have used a join function, inner join function, to get the same result. But this is not always the case. This is true particularly for inner queries using the where clause, right? So you can get the same output using the inner join, but as I said, it will not always be the case. There are many, many tasks which cannot be completed without the use of subqueries. So this was a very, very simple exercise. Please go through this again, because in our next class, we are going to write a very big query wherein we will solve a very big task. Okay. So here we have done two things. First, we saw the exist clause and we saw the in clause. In case of in clause, it will search through all these values, get the output for all these values. In case of exist, it will go row by row. If the row is true, if the row matches, you will get the output. If the row does not match, you will not get the output. So that is it. Thank you. In the next class, we'll start with the exercise.